Let us learn various terms associated with biodiversity, species, ecosystem, and habitat. What is a species? It is quite confusing. Actually, whenever we talk about species, we say these are the different varieties of organisms. Like here we have zebra, monkey, and a woodpecker. All three are different organisms. If they can produce offspring, they must be the same species, right? Let us take the example of a zebra and a horse. Their offspring is known as zebroid. But when a zebroid is mated with another zebroid, it can't produce offsprings. So, species is a group of organisms that can reproduce to produce fertile offspring. Let us learn what is an ecosystem. This term ecosystem was coined by A.G. Tensley in the year 1935. Eco means the region of space where organisms live, and the system is formed by interaction of organisms. So we can say that an ecosystem comprises of various communities of living organisms like algae, water plants, turtles, pond snail, freshwater mussels, mosquito, pond skater, fishes, microbes, etc. Similarly, it also consists of sunlight, temperature, water, dissolved oxygen. When we particularly talk about a pond ecosystem, we know that all these living and non-living components interact among themselves as well as with their physical environment in which they occur. So, ecosystem is made up of all the plants, animals, and microorganisms in an area. They have biotic components like producers, which make their own food. For example, algae and water plants. Biotic components are consumers, like primary consumers, which directly feed on producers. For example, protozoans and crustaceans. Then there are secondary consumers, like frog, insects, small fishes. And then we have tertiary consumers, fishes and snakes. Bacteria are also present in a pond ecosystem. The third one is decomposers, aquarium, which feed on dead organic matter, which convert it into simple soluble inorganic molecules that can be taken. Abiotic components of an ecosystem include inorganic substances like carbon dioxide, water, nitrogen, sulfur, calcium, phosphorus, etc. These also have organic components like proteins, carbohydrates, lipids, etc. Abiotic components also include climatic factors like temperature, light, wind, water, soil, and rainfall. Types of ecosystem. There are two types of ecosystem, natural and artificial. Natural ecosystem can further be terrestrial ecosystem like grassland, forest, desert. Aquatic ecosystem naturally can be marine ecosystem, for example oceans, freshwater ecosystems like lakes. Artificial ecosystems include aquarium and crop fields. Let us learn about habitat, the living place of an organism. It is the place where an organism, whether a plant or an animal, lives and have other factors included also. Everything that surrounds living things and affects their growth and development is called environment. It can be living as well as non-living. Habitat is actually the natural surroundings where a living organism lives. Habitat provides an organism with everything it needs to survive, like food, shelter, and proper climatic conditions, like pond, forest, river, desert. In a pond or a river, we have plants as well as animals in it. On the trees, we have monkeys, insects. In the desert, we have camel as well as desert plants. Similarly, in the forest, we have a large variety of wild animals as well as wild plants. So, accordingly, we can have various types of habitat. Like, the habitat which is present on the earth is known as terrestrial habitat, like deserts, mountains and grasslands, forests. We have a number of terrestrial organisms like cow, buffalo, pig, hen, etc. Similarly, we have aquatic habitat like lakes, oceans, rivers, ponds and aquatic organisms like fishes, aquatic plants like lotus, etc. We have arboreal habitat also, in which the organisms live on the trees, like monkeys, gorilla. Aerial habitat includes the organisms which mostly span their lifespan in air. And there is amphibious habitat too, which have animals like frogs, toads, crocodiles, living both on land as well as water. Components of a habitat include living components as well as non-living components. Living components include plants and animals and are also known as biotic components. And non-living components are soil, rocks, temperature, light, etc. and are known as abiotic. Thanks for watching.